Today, I'm gonna show you the 5 best tricks for creating acting animation in Blender. Remember to stay until the end because there's gonna be a bonus rig. Secondly, remember to like and subscribe. That helps the channel in growing and for me to be able to create more videos. I'm Luciano and welcome to the adventures of LollypopMan. The Rain character was recently released by the Blender team. They haven't done any movies with it. It's a particular project that they created to explain the entire character creation process from design to final rig. I think there's a test animation somewhere.
Hey there, ladies. Hi, my name is Amy and I'll be your waitress today.
And yeah, I really like this character. It's very appealing. I've only tested it a little bit. It's really fast. The facials are really nice and the body rig is made of something that looks like rigify, so it's super light to use. Four of the rigs that we're going to see today are all made with Blend Rig. And so Blend Rig is an auto rig created by Juan Pablo Bosa.
Non-Spanish speakers may call me JP.
And he used it to rig a few of the characters of the open movies created by the Blender Animation Studio. So one of those is this one.
My name is Victor.
And so the rig is fully fledged, has all of the facial controls you need. You have pivots, you have bendy arms, you can scale everything.
How would you know?
The Victor rig is a part of the Cosmos Laundromat project that happened a couple of years ago. One of the reasons I really like this character is because it's super high quality in every way. If you look at the textures and everything, it's a very, very well-made character. Secondly, because this movie was done at the Blender Animation Studio, the animation quality is really high.
Hi.
And so that lets you know that maybe the character seems overcomplicated, but it's perfectly usable because of what we've seen already. I want to consider them as one because they come from the same movie and they are both the same rig as Victor rig. One thing that I really like about these two characters is because they're both designed for the same movie, they live in the same environment, so they're kind of familiar. You can use them for making one piece between the two of them and they don't feel out of place, which is great.
Just a trim, please. BORIS
AGENT TRAITOR! I'm not gonna touch up on the other characters that they have, but they have a bunch more. They have like all of the henchmen and Fu Manchu, the bad character that's in the cave. They have the barber as well. So there's kind of like a family of characters there that works really well with each other. So if you need to do a piece with several characters, that's actually a good choice.
Looks like we've found our next recruit. Doctor, carry on with the procedure. We have to make room for Agent 327.
These are also rigged with Blend Rig, so if you learn how to use the other one, you learn how to use this one, and the same with BORIS. BORIS has a different jacket, so it's slightly different. You have more controllers to control the button top and stuff like that. Once you're able to pick and choose the controllers you want to use, they are fairly easy to use as well.
Find my friend, a nice Jewish doctor.
Ivan is a character made by Nikolai Mamashev. And this also lives on the Blend Rig. So if you learn how to use the other three that we just talked about, you can use this one as well. So it wouldn't be too hard to learn again. The difference is that this character is much more on a 2D style, as you can see, also renders really fast. And as all of the other ones, they were done in the age of Blender 2.79, but they should not have any problems running in 2.8. This character is super appealing also to do more kind of body mechanics as well, but because it's rigged with Blend Rig, I wanted to mention that you can use this for acting perfectly because it has still all of the controls that you need. Judy Hops is another free rig. You can find it in Blend Swap, link down in the description. And I really like this character because obviously Zootopia, hey, who doesn't want to animate something from a movie we all love? It's not a super flexible face, but it has enough. Still, you can push the character to get some good acting.
Oh. Okay.
What are you going to do with these rigs? Let me know in the comments below. What are your intentions? What kind of audio you want to do? What acting piece are you planning to do for your reel? I'd love to hear that. Let's go to the bonus round. So the bonus round is Jim. Jim is a character I found a couple of days ago, just out of luck. And I really like how appealing the character is. Also, as kind of like with Rain, the body and the clothes are not super specific. So you can use it for more different situations that you can imagine. Difference with like Judy Hopps, which is already dressed like a cop, or Boris, which looks like a bad guy already, kind of, right? Obviously, you can play with those expectations, but these ones are clearly more generic in that way, so it allows for more freedom. I really like how the facials look in this rig. It looks like the body is made with Rigify and the face is custom. The only downside of this rig is it's $35 on Gumroad. But if you're looking to do a piece with a super appealing character, I don't think it's gonna kill you. Mostly considering that there are not that many options in Blender of a character of this quality. It also reminds me a little bit of one of the characters from Paperman, or the Jack character from the Anim Squad rig. So it has that little kind of more Disney feeling. Hope you like this video. Remember that all the links for reaching these characters are gonna be in the description. And yeah, remember to like and subscribe, and see me next time.